Hi Cloud Gurus, I'm Mel Marquez, and welcome to Linux This Month, the show giving you the latest and most important news in the Linux world. Now today we're going to be covering the latest updates to the Linux kernel, which were announced with the release of kernel 5.8-RC3. That one can be a mouthful. There are also big changes for OpenSUSE, but before we delve into the kernel, let's take a look at this month's noteworthy news. So get your man pages ready, because we're going to jump on in. First up this month, Linux Mint released Linux Mint 20, aka Ulana. Now, although this release occurred in late June, I think it's still important to note because it's a long-term supported release, which means it's going to be supported until 2025. The release includes options for Cinnamon, Mate, and XFCE. LinuxFS has released version 10.3. It's also dubbed WindowsFX, and it's an interesting distribution as the graphical desktop is designed to feel and look just like Windows 10. It has a modified Cinnamon desktop environment that might suit you best. It has a Windows 10 style taskbar, systems tray, and curiously, it displays the Windows logo before booting up. Microsoft has now unveiled a new threat detection service for Linux. Project Frida, you're gonna have to look that one up, is a cloud-based tool for Linux that is able to detect malicious software, such as rootkits. Microsoft's research blog states that this is a roadmap towards trusted sensing for the cloud that can allow enterprises to engage in regular, complete discovery sweeps for undetected malware. SUSE, the world's largest independent open source company and developers of SUSE Linux Enterprise, has entered an agreement to acquire Rancher Labs. Rancher Labs offers a variety of Kubernetes products, which allows management of Kubernetes operations that can be deployed and managed at scale. Now, an important question for me is, DEF CON actually canceled this year? I'm sad to report that DEF CON in Vegas has indeed been canceled this year, because DEF CON is going into safe mode, aka virtual, keeping the same dates of August 6th through 9th. But better yet, this year, it's free. The third annual DEF CON, and that's DEF CON, now has its call for presentations open. This is a free technology conference happening from September 23rd through 25th. It covers a range of topics from system engineering focusing on low-level workings of Linux to the user experience with open source technologies. But now it's time for us to move over into our info pages and take a deep dive into some exciting announcements made this month. Linus Torvald has released Linux kernel 5.8-C3PO. And though it won't be out as, hold on, that was Linux kernel 5.8-RC3. And though it won't be out as a stable release to early in August, Linux enthusiasts are ready to jump on in. Now, originally it was thought to be the biggest release ever, with over 15,000 mergers, 8,000 lines of new code, and 14,000 files expected to be changed. Now that's a lot of changes. That was so much so that Linus, our beloved dictator, even wrote to the Linux mailing list. I don't think that there's anything particularly scary here, and the size of this RC is probably simply a direct result of the fact that 5.8 is a big release. He did wrap up saying, "Let's see what happens during the rest of the release." It seems that he called it correctly, because July found the release actually being on the smaller side. But what does this release bring? About half of these updates are drivers, from networking to sound to USB. The remaining includes a variety of upgrades, from security enhancements to updates to the core kernel. The community is now speculating that given the timeline for the release, this might be the kernel release that is shipped with Ubuntu 20.10 and Fedora 33 later this year. For a comprehensive list of changes, visit the links available in the resource list. OpenSUSE has released version 15.2. This release brings software updates, security fixes, and an improved installer offering better management of storage devices for the Raspberry Pi. It also brings new technologies such as TensorFlow, a free and open source software library, helping develop and train machine learning models. Marco Velez, developer for this project, states, "Leap 15.2 represents a huge step forward in artificial intelligence space. OpenSUSE end users can now finally consume machine learning and deep learning frameworks and applications via our repositories." And if SUSE is going to get some new container technology, what about OpenSUSE? Included in this release are several container options, including Kubernetes and the container runtime interface. The most exciting part for me, though, a completely new setting dialog that manages color profiles, allowing for out-of-the-box support for colored managed printing and scanning. Yes! And that's all for this month. Here's to a kernel panic-free month. I can't wait to see you for more Linux updates on Linux this month. Till then, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.